Season 1 has received a lot of changes, and eventually Season 2 and Season 3 will receive these changes as well. In this video, I'm talking about all the changes done to Season 1, how good they are, and how they can help you to progress on this game. Hello guys, WilsonBox here. I hope you guys are having a great day. I created a new account, a new free-to-play account, and I think you already noticed there are a lot of content creators creating free-to-play accounts. And this doesn't mean we're gonna stop playing on our main account, so just to be clear, this is just to experience all the changes done to Season 1. If they done these changes to Season 2 and Season 3, then we will not need to do these new free-to-play accounts just to test all of these changes. So this video is to show you guys to know how good these changes are, and eventually they'll come to Season 2 and Season 3, and I hope they are gonna help us a lot, and we receive some compensation as well. So, this is my day 5 on this account, completely 100% free to play, and I must say the new changes are really, really, really good. So let's start talking about the dungeons. So one of the first changes they done is that now we have 12 stages. So on every dungeon we have now 12 changes. So it doesn't really mean that we are going to receive more rewards, but at the same time it kind of means it's gonna happen that, because on the last stage we have, as you guys can see on this arrow, so on the last stage we have a really high chance to drop a mythic item, and as well we are sure that we're gonna receive one legendary and some more of these materials. Meanwhile on Season 3, where we only have the stage 9, there's only chances to get this stuff, and there is not a 100% chance to get this amount of materials. We can get more or less, but there's nothing guaranteed. In this new stage, this 12th stage, we have 100% chance to get at least this stuff, and then we have a higher chance comparing to the other stages to get a mythic. So last 3, we get a chance to get a mythic one, last 1 will be a higher chance. Regarding the dungeons, there are also another one that is really, really good and helps a lot. So on Goblin Lair, now we don't need to be moving around on all the Goblin Lairs. So on Season 2 and Season 3, we need to jump in from one Goblin Lair 1 to Goblin Lair 2 to Goblin Lair 3. On this one, they need a simple change that helps a lot to save us some more time. So all the stages are in the same Goblin Lair, so if we want to progress on these stages, we don't need to move around, we can keep on the same one and keep climbing until stage 12. So it's also stage 12. I think this is really good. This is just day 5, so yeah, obviously I can reach stage 12 on any dungeon, but I'm sure this is gonna help a lot with the drops. And this one regarding Goblin Lair will save us some time. We don't need to be jumping around switching between Goblin Lair 1, 2 and 3. But regarding the other dungeons like Grave of Venom or Grave of Curse, I think we'll increase our chances to get really good drops, really good mythics, and that is gonna help us a lot. Then we have this new season journey, so this is helping a lot as well. I really like these changes they did. So we have the heroic journey, and this one we had before, and we already can get a lot of stuff here. So as you guys can see, we can get 4, 5, 6 Aeolite Dice from here, and then 4, 5, 6, 700 of Wyrmrow and 1 free Epic Legendary, and then 4, 5, 6, 7 of the Legendary Scrolls. With help, this will help a lot. So we get the free Legendary, Aeolite Dice, Wyrmrow. We were able to get this before, but now we have the 7 day journey that will help us a lot. So we have these 7 days, guys, where we can get a lot of stuff. As you guys can see, we can get some more extra breads, tickets to farm gold, Wyrmrow. Like every day we have different missions that we need to do, and with this we are getting some extra rewards, and this lasts for lots. I don't think this is limited to any days, so we have a plenty of time. We don't need to do this like every day like day one. You don't need to finish all of this. You have enough time to finish this as long as you are playing on season one. You can finish this whenever you want. And then we are getting some extra rewards. So we get all of these ones, as you can see guys, some affinity as well. This helps a lot with our progress, and then we get more 10 yellow light dices from here. We get a free legendary, Charlash, which can help a lot on our progress if we don't get enough legendaries from the yellow light dices. Then we get more 5 legendary scrolls and 1 legendary artifact, so this is a big boost. If we don't get good legendaries, we can use these ones that the game are giving to us. And just to give you an idea, so I'm day 5, and without spending any money on this game, I was able to do 54 summons. So 54 summons, and I already got, from these 54 summons, I got the Charlash. Yep, Charlash. I don't even know the name. How is it? Charlash, yeah. So you got the Charlash, it's a free one, so it's 1 legendary. Then I got the Trollgar, I got Donella, and I got this guy, Wuldork. So at the moment I've already 4 legendaries without spending $1, and I will get the other guy, what's the name of him? Erich. I'll get Erich as well, so it'll be 5. And then I don't know how much I did of summons, but I know at least I'm getting 2 more from here. So guys, 2 more from here for sure. I'm getting 1 eventually before the 80, and then I will get the free one at 80 for sure. So I will getting 2 more. So 2 more legendaries plus Erich, so will be 5, 6, 7, 7 legendaries just from the summons in 1 month. I think in 1 month I will do the other Eliolite summons I need to, and then I'll get 7 legendaries. So I think this is a really big boost to everyone playing on Season 1. Then another change that is really, really good they did to Season 1, and all of this will come to Season 2 and 3. Of course, this season journey, we can't go back to get all of these rewards. These ones, they need to compensate us, give us some sort of compensation regarding these rewards, because we are not getting these ones. So the Faymander, there are some really good changes. So the first one is the Labyrinth of Curiosities. Now it has 38 stages, and each one it looks like the Faymander before. So each stage we need to do it, we need to walk around, kill 4 monsters, get 2 chests, and that's it. And we can get really good rewards from this. And then Faymander, it's much better. So we have 200 stages, but it's 200, it's not anymore like before. So now we just need to do one of the stages. So I'm just gonna start one just to show you guys. So when we start the Faymander, we go here and we just need to fight the first ones. You fight these ones, I don't think I can win, but let's have a try. My team is not that strong. Let me just change something here. So we have the 10 times speed. Not sure if I can win this one. Oh, maybe he can win. No, he can't. Yeah, but you guys understand what's the light here. So after you killing this stage, after you're doing this stage, you can go directly to the next stage. You don't need to be going around and cleaning everything. Just this one, you get a reward, you go the next one. Much easier. And now we also have the daily reward. So this is a really good incentive to keep progressing on these levels and also giving you extra rewards. So if you are between stage 1 and 44 and 49, you are getting something daily. So the higher stage you are, imagine if you are between stage 100 and 200, you are getting every day some more affinity and some more yellow SS of creation, and this will help a lot to level up our artifacts. So this is a daily reward, as you guys can see. Every day we are getting some of these. This is a big boost to everyone playing on Season 1 now. Comparing with Season 3, we don't have the daily rewards. To progress on these stages, it takes much more time because it's like the Labyrinth of Curiosities now. I can show you because, yeah, I did the ones I can. But it's the same thing as before. We need to walk around, kill the 4 monsters, collect the 2 chests, and then after clearing the stage, we can go to the next level. Then we have also some changes on Arena, and these ones, they are done into Season 2 and 3 as well. And these are really good as well. I really like these changes then. So now we can fight these ones, and these rewards, now it's really worth it that you set a good lineup defense to you. So just make sure you are using the best defense as you can, because it's going to help you a lot So I'm just gonna set this up for me. Just gonna do some changes here because I need to have a good defense. Yeah, you need to have a good defense always, because you are getting the best rewards if you keep your place on the PvP arena. And now it's pretty easy. So as you guys can see, I'm on this account, I'm 757. You can choose between these guys, the one you want to fight. So you can challenge it, do the fight. We have the 10 times speed now. So we're just gonna do this really quick and that's it. And now I'm taking the place of this guy. So now I'm 538 because I won. And then I get one win row. So it's one win row for every win or loss you are doing. If you can't, so imagine now that you can't win these stages, any of this one, like the easiest one. Imagine if I can't win this one, I can go just to do a quick challenge, do as much as I want, manage just one. I can challenge now and I get the same rewards as I was winning on a battle. And this is much easier. Imagine if you don't have time to do any arena on that day, you can just come here and use all of your tickets here and get the rewards from this arena. I think these changes are really good, but these ones are applying to Season 2 and Season 3 as well. Another change that is really good is that now we can get some journey experience from doing any stage of these ones. I think it's 10. So guys, as you can see, we get journey experience for every stage that we do. So if we are farming, we are getting more journey experience. So it's the only downside is that if you are buying all of these stamina, this one here, if you are buying this every day, these four ones, so it means if you are a whale and you have more Wyrm Row, you are spending all your Wyrm Row on more experience, you are going to progress your journey level faster. But it's not much faster because you are only getting 10 for each run you do. Regarding the players that want to spend some money on this game, there are some really nice deals now. So when you start Season 1, you start with this epic chest that you can get. You have all the season to buy it. It's less than $1, so it's really worth it if you want to get one of the best epics on this game, like Frubart or Garius. Really worth it. And if you spend $1 here, you are getting this as well, the Gift of Life. You are getting V-Cook, two epic scrolls, color scrolls, and some gold as well. These are really good deals, but it doesn't stop there. So if we go back here and we go to the store, imagine if you have that extra money and you're really enjoying the game and you want to spend some more, then you can find even a better deal. So if you go here, there's this one, it's $1 as well, that are getting you some rare gear, some bread, and 20 starlight ices, which is really good. It's a really good one as well. And then you have this one. So if you are buying, I think this is just for if you are like more a whale, this one, which is $100, which is a bit more if you want to spend. But if you want to, you can get these ones, okay? So with 700, you are getting 25 Elite Ices and one more legendary artifact. And then if you spend 3,000 here, imagine you can just spend 3,000 here and it's still worth it. 3,000 here gives you more 10 Elite Ices, gives you Master Scrolls and one more legendary. So imagine if you are spending money here without any summons, you already have two summon legendaries and two legendary artifacts that are the best ones for these characters. Then we have another shop. So now we have the owner shop, and this one, I don't have any rewards, but as far as I know, this one, you can get these honor tokens, these Medal of Honors. You can get them with seasonal events and stuff like that. I've not done any event that was giving me these rewards, but as soon as I get it, I will discover how you can get this. But it's an extra way to get some more rewards in this game. Another change done to Season 1 as well, and I'm sure this one will come to Season 3 and 2 as well. So it's the AFK leveling. So now we can go to our camping. We go here to our hero, and you can set one hero to be automatically leveling. So I think I will be able to get more 3 slots. So eventually I'll get 4 slots to level up all our heroes. So as you guys can see, there's all of these slots. I can't activate them. I need to find this pioneer item, and eventually I will able to unlock these slots and use them to level up more heroes. So there's one more here. So I'm not sure if it will be five. Maybe it will be five slots, but at least four or five slots. I will discover this to level up our heroes. And these ones, you don't need to spend any resources. But still, when they reach like level 30 or 50, you still need to spend some materials to level up from 2 stars to 3 stars, 4 stars, 5 stars. But the Goblin Lair, you don't need the materials for Goblin Lair to level up them. Another thing I noticed is now that we have like some specific gear they created. So we have this gear, as you guys can see. Sorry, I don't know what is this, what is happening with my screen. But this one is giving us some extra stats to do some stages. And I know I have these ones. As you guys can see, this one is for tank. It's the Chaotic Halo, and it gives some defense, some shield. It's really, really good. There's another one. Where is the other one? So we have this one. So this one just for Goblin Lair, as you guys can see. So this one will generate a toxic spore when killing a Goblin Lair. So it's going to help you to kill the Goblin Lair stages much faster. And now I got this one. And this one is to improve the damage on Vortex. So this one will increase the damage on Temporal Vortex, and the damage bonus is increased by 15%. These ones are really like this. It's really good because it's helping us with this new gear. It's helping us to do some of the stages if you are having some difficulty doing it at the beginning. Another thing about Season 1 is also the Psycho Core and the Affinity Tree. So the Affinity Tree is now a bit different as it was before. Now we can have this attack up at the first one. We have some more HP here and some more defense up here. And then we have all of these slots for every element. And each one can give you a lot of stats. So the first one will give you 24% attack. And this one 24% more HP. And as you guys can see, I'm day 5, and the rate you can get is as a free to player is really, really good with all the new changes. Then this will be, as always, accuracy and resistance for every element. And then we get this one is for the 3 heroes as well. So we are getting more elemental damage here, and this one taking less damage. And these are the final ones that applies to 5 elements. So each one will increase your damage for each element. And these ones will decrease the damage you are taking. And then the last ones, you are getting some more fire poison damage for all the deployed heroes. And for the lightning radiance will be crit damage. And for ice necrosis will be the damage dealt by heroes. But now we don't have any reducing damage on the last tier. The last change I want to talk about, and this one was done to Season 2 and Season 3, is that the new map interface. So the new map interface is really good. I really like all of the what they've done here. So now we have the areas here, but you don't need to use it anymore. You can just go here, select the area you want to go. If you're not farmed all of these ones, you can go back and do it. If you want to select the dungeons, the challenges are all here: Temporal Vortex, Grand Arena, and then the exercise will be Foemander and Pillar of Thrill. You can go here. It's much easier to find the places that we want to go. So guys, this was all the changes I want to talk about. I really like this. I really like all the work they did with Season 1. It looks much better, especially if you want to be a 100% free to play. This is much easier. You are getting a lot of stuff without spending any money on this game. You can get some legendaries. And if you want to spend some money, then you have really good deals on Season 1 now that are really worth it if you want to. And all the changes they are done, it makes the game much fluid, much easier. We are still getting those locked quests. So as you guys could see, there are some stages of the dungeons I can do because I've not got enough journey level. But I mean, that's okay, because with this we have more time to focus on our farming and everything. And I mean, I already know what to expect from this game, so it's kind of easier for me to do all the quests. But for new players especially, this will be really good. So if you're already playing on season 3 or 2, I don't think it's worth it to go back and do all over again. If you are playing on season 2 and you don't have like good characters and you are 100% free to player, maybe it's a good chance, it's a good option to start it over again because you are getting some extra legendaries. But I'm almost 100% sure they will compensate us and they will give us this hero to every player on season 2 and season 3, because every player on season 1 will, I'm sure they will be able to get this, because you just need to do these quests and you don't have like a limited time to do it. I mean, you have like 3 months, you have the season 1 to finish this, as far as I know. So I think every player on season 1 will get this, so I hope they will compensate us with these Heliolite Dices, with these scrolls and this artifact and this legendary, because that's what season 1 players will get. So guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope this helps you a lot to know about all the changes were done to season 1, how good they are, and hoping these changes will come as soon as possible to season 2 and season 3. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, don't forget to press that like button. If you are not a subscriber yet, make sure to subscribe to my channel to follow more content like this. Thanks for watching and see you next time.